Hi, how's it going? My name's Rahul Neelam Carvel, and welcome to my teaching resource on the important topic of how to draw Homer Simpson. As most people know, The Simpsons is a cartoon television sitcom created by Matt Groening in the late 80s. Since its debut, this satirical parody of a working-class American family has run for over 20 series, broadcast over 450 episodes, and won literally dozens of awards. A lot of this is down to the character of Homer Simpson, the father of the family. Crude, overweight, lazy and clumsy, yet also fiercely devoted to his family, Homer has become one of the most famous comic creations in television history. In this resource, using a step-by-step approach, I aim to teach the basics of drawing Homer Simpson, and hopefully cartoons in general. To do this, you will need some paper, a sharp pencil, a rubber, some coloured pencils or crayons, and finally a black felt tip pen. Alright, so first off we're going to begin by drawing three circles. A big one at the top to denote Homer's head, and then underneath that two other circles, a small one and a big one, to represent his body. Then underneath that we're going to draw two lines to represent his feet. On top of this, we're now going to add some more lines to help represent the direction which Homer's facing. Vertical lines represent whether he's facing left or right, while horizontal lines denote whether he's facing up or down. The more curved the line, the more pronounced the direction. In addition, we can also add the two upper lines represent his upper limbs as well. Okay, so now using the circles as a guide, we can add some features to them. The eyes are essentially just two big round circles, but try and make sure the pupils are facing the same way, as otherwise you'll end up looking a bit dizzy. The mouth is probably the hardest bit, so be sure to take your time over that. In addition to that, we can add the ears, the roof of the head, as well as features like his hair, singular, on top and on the side of his ear. Okay, so now you can continue using the circle to draw in the features of Homer's body. Like most cartoon characters, his body is relatively small in relation to the head. If you just sort of, in terms of like proportions, it's about the same as sort of a baby's head to a baby's body. So it's probably worth bearing that in mind when you are adding features to the circles. So we've finished the basic outline now, so just rub out the initial guidelines to give you a clear picture of the outline of Homer Simpson. Okay, so now we can add some colour. The important thing to bear in mind here is to try and keep an even tone to the shading, to replicate the look of the cartoon. It's often quite good to shade in small circles, as this helps to eliminate the appearance of distinct pencil marks. This is a bit discretionary, but sometimes it's nice to add definition as well. To do this, go around the edges of the cartoon in a slightly darker tone. You can also add a background as well, so that Homer stands out. Finally, using a felt tip pen, carefully go over the lines so that Homer is clearly defined.